All right, we'll take your calls now, continuing with Tim Staples on the five non-negotiables here on Catholic Answers Live, and go to Lincoln, Nebraska, and on KVSS, we say hi to Richard. Hey, Richard.
Thanks, Patrick and Tim, for taking my call.
Welcome.
Welcome to you, sir.
All this is well and good for the electorate and the candidates that we're voting for, but when a solitary judge overturns Prop 8 out in California, what are the voters to do?
Yes, what are
they? Hey, I got a new sound effect. That's great.
That's right. Well, Richard, it's a great question. And I think this is something that we talk about in the voter's guide as well as the CD set here.
Okay.
Is voters have to realize that when you go to the voting booth, you are not only voting for candidates for president or governor just for them, but you're also voting for the judges that they are going to appoint. And so this is another reason why we as Catholics, and I make the argument, not only for governor and president, but on the lowest levels of government, we have to consider these issues because that's where politicians get started. These issues are important at every, I know a lot of folks don't agree with me on that, Patrick, but on every level of politics, we need to be voting for pro-life. So wait a second, now what you're talking about dog catcher? Say, you know what? Politicians start on the local level and move their way up. We've got to impact every level of our culture, and we have to start thinking that way. Now, Richard, there's no doubt. I mean, it can be argued. We're talking tyranny here for one judge to be able to overrule the will of the people. And you know, not just the will of the people here, but we're talking about the belief and the practice of every culture in the history of the world, and we're going to overturn it one guy against the will of the people of California. I mean, that's huge. Now, we have redress here. It's being appealed to the Supreme Court of California, and it will go to the Supreme Court perhaps. But again, Richard, I emphasize that if we put pro-life candidates into these key positions, then the judges will not be the radicals that we see all over the United States on state level as well as federal level. We have judges who are radicals and who are openly advocating radical positions today.
Mm-hmm. Richard, does that make sense?
Yeah, let's distribute your CD set to the judiciary.
Hey, I'm all in favor.
And thanks for agreeing to underwrite that, Richard. That's powerful. Thank you, Richard.
I'll sponsor that, yes.
All right. Well, thanks for your call. It's a great question.
And say hi to your congressman for us.
I will.
Very, very good. Jeffrey Fortenberry. Very good
at
man.
At noon mass tomorrow, I'll see him probably.
Excellent. Do that. Give him an inappropriately hard punch in the shoulder for me.
All right. I will.
God bless, Richard. Thanks for
Thank
the call.
Thank you.